shut up in my bones.
I feel fire, and then
I'm about to blow. Gotta tell the world about this desire.
In my heart, in my soul, it feels right. Everybody I'm touching gonna see the light.
Contagious,
can't hold it.
Contagious.
Now's the time to ignite and arise with our eyes in the skies and our hands in the air.
General.
I guess that my life is identical,
yeah. To every sinner in general. Now I'm beginning to see, in order to change, fucking the blame. It's all beginning with me, with me.
Got me thinking about cat,
thinking about cat.
On the way to safe, on the way to safe. It's pitching the fire,
pitching the fire.
Bring them to Jesus,
bring them to Jesus. My whole team, whole regime on a sin. Turn up. I think of the hood, I think of my city. They say that I'm losing my mind. I tell them I'm fine, I tell them I'm God. Before we run out of time, this is the mission, we get it. Like Dorian, I am a witness, he did it. The work on the cross is finished, and guilty is innocent.
Shut up in my bones, shut up in my bones. I'm about to blow, gotta tell the world about this desire.
My heart, my soul, it feels right. Everybody I'm touching gonna see the light.
Contagious,
can't hold it,
contagious.
Now's the time to ignite and arise when the eyes are
scattered. Light it up!
We setting fire to everything, telling them who is the king. Diminishing all of his enemies, he is the king of the ring. Who is this giving us life and forgiving us via his seat on the throne? Who is igniting the fire, enticing desire inside of his own?
Hey! What's up? Y'all didn't know we were hiding.
What up?
Hey, welcome back to the Social Distance Youth Group Night.
That's right.
Yeah.
Can't keep us down. Glad you're here. Hope you're ready to spend about 20 minutes or so having fun with us, thinking about God's word and encouraging each other.
That's right. Hey, before we go any further, right. I want to ask you guys to do something.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Sound off, all right? Let us know that you're here in our chat section over here. Or is it over there?
Somewhere.
It's over here. All right? You know, give an emoji or a what's up or
what's
something.
Up?
Just so that we know that you're here tonight, because we want to know that you're here tonight.
Right. But before all that, first, a game to win a prize. All you got to do is get involved. You got a shot. You need Joyce's number.
Oh, it should be right here.
And a camera phone.
Or over there.
All right.
It might be on this side.
Somewhere.
I'm not sure, but you should find it. All right. That's right. Because tonight,
yeah.
Starting now,
uh-oh,
it's at-home scavenger hunt time.
Ooh.
All right. So when we tell you the object to find, this is what you do. All right. You take a selfie with it. And then you text me. All right. My phone number. Somewhere in this region. Somewhere on the screen.
Somewhere.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you don't know my phone number, get it and put it in your phone real quick. All right. You take a selfie with it. You take a selfie with the object. Okay. And then you text it to me. And the first two people that get their text to me win a prize. Hey, we got a couple of fun little Starbucks cards.
Ooh.
Oh, Chick-fil-A cards.
Chick-fil-A.
What?
Plus, yeah, everybody that participates will be put in our prize drawing for next week.
That's right. It's going to be cool.
It's going to be good, so you don't want to miss your chance for that.
All right. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Dawn, I'm looking at you, girl. Either put your shoes on or take your socks off.
Or get some slippers.
No! Slippers slip!
Uh-huh.
Quick service announcement for everybody.
Uh-huh.
All right? This is just a game. It's not a full contact sport.
Right.
All right? Watch out for your cat. Don't go tripping
over
the cat falling down the stairs.
Yeah.
Okay, don't body slam your dad, because if y'all start getting hurt, we have to discontinue this game.
We don't want that.
And I get to keep these.
I mean, if that's the case, though.
We don't want that.
Anyways,
we don't want that. All right?
No. But the first item to be found and to take a selfie with, remember that. Yeah, is a toothbrush.
Go. In the meantime, fun and game. Hey, in boxing, if you hit somebody and it's a low blow, they call it
a low blow. Gunshot.
What do you wear
a belt
to keep your pants up? And if you do under.
Underbelt.
Uh-huh. Except another word for under is
below
yes.
The belt.
Yes.
All right, so when a quarterback throws a really far throw,
Hail Mary.
Yes.
Oh, booyah! Hey, as kids, you like to go out and you play in the backyard, and there's this wooden thing that looks like a square, uh-huh. and inside it is granules of something.
Sandbox.
Yes! Oh, yeah! Oh, no!
It's a poker game. What's the name? It's
Texas Hold'em.
Yes.
Oh. Okay. Hey, everybody these days has an electronic device that has a screen.
Phone. Okay. Cell phone.
But you type.
Touch screen. No. Computer. Laptop.
It was computer. Wow. Okay. Hey, congratulations. Congratulations to the winner, whoever
right.
you are. And I'm going to tell you who won in the chat section if I haven't already done that.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, are you ready?
Uh-oh,
for the next one.
It's a twofer.
All right, hey, the next item is a textbook. Go!
Oh, go, 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 go!
Okay, this person wears a hat. And
cowboy.
And they go to places where they compete, and it's in a rink, and they have the cowboys, and they have people doing barrel races, and it's a...
Competition.
Yeah! Yes, it's a competition, but it's a special competition for cowboys. Hey.
Rodeo.
Yes!
It's like the things that you said that's at a beach, right? The brown stuff.
Sand.
Okay, sand.
Castle.
No, but then when you try to like get somebody entangled in something, you call it a what?
Sand trap.
Yes.
Oh, what's up now? Okay, hey, this is something I like to do. I get on my phone.
Uh-huh.
I do it with my children, and we go and we find. I call it treasure hunting with my kids.
Yes.
Do you remember what it's called?
No.
Okay, that's geocaching. All right, this is a game. It's not checkers, but it's
chess.
Nope, it's actually checkers. My
bench. Hey!
I think I broke my bench. I got too excited in my seat and I broke it.
I hope you didn't.
I know. At least I can get a splinter in my gluteus.
Anyways, thanks everyone who played. I hope that was as fun for you as it was for us.
Yeah. You know. All right. So hey, it was fun. All right. But we're gonna change gears for a minute. Right? So we're gonna bring it down.
Yeah.
All right. Hope you guys have fun with that. All right. Hope nobody got hurt. Don't be getting no hurt. All right.
Please don't.
Please don't.
We love you.
We don't want your parents to be like, no, you're not going to youth group anymore.
Jesus loves you too.
That wouldn't be good. All right. So, but we're going to change gears.
Okay.
And get you guys to think just a little bit. All right. So, this is what we're going to do. We're going to have our blackboard question.
Hey.
Okay. Those of you guys that go to the Southeastern, you probably have an idea of what I'm talking about when I say that. I'm going to ask you a question,
mm-hmm.
okay, and invite you to write a response on our blackboard wall. Now, our Southeastern people understand what that is because we do it almost every Wednesday night.
Right.
Right. But those of you that aren't from Southeastern, and hey, we're glad you're here. Any of you guys from North Central or from across the country in Texas or whatever. Hey, we're glad you're with us. So, we're going to do our blackboard wall.
Mm-hmm. Except we don't have a blackboard. So what we're going to do is invite you to write your answer out in the chat section.
That's right. That's right. In the chat section. So please feel free to share and give your thoughts. Give your thoughts on what the question is, and just we want to do this so that we stay connected, right?
Yeah.
We want to do this so that we keep together and share a little bit. But I would encourage you maybe to text a friend from youth group and give them an encouraging word.
Right.
Let them know that you care about them, that you're glad that you know them, and that you're glad they're alive and part of your life,
mm-hmm.
Because that's a big deal, right?
Yeah, yeah. We're not trying to pressure you into anything.
No.
We're just trying to stay connected. And if you're willing to, go ahead and share.
Yeah, over here in the chat section.
Yeah.
So, okay, so here's our blackboard question.
Okay.
Can you think of a time when someone has tricked you or lied to you or betrayed you in some way that maybe in a funny way or maybe in a way that hurt? And if you can you think about or can you type up that occurrence in maybe a sentence or two.
Okay.
Let's go ahead and do that now.
I'd be lying if I said I wasn't tired of trying, and now I'm down to my last excuse. So here I am waiting for you. When I take the wheel and everything starts falling apart, I start to wander off the road that leads to your heart. Still there you are. In the broken, when I'm losing my way, when I'm lost in all the doubt and the shame, you remain.
All right, hey, thank you all for your participation in whatever way you did, whether it was the blackboard question, or you sang, or you texted a friend, and encouraged them and just let them know that you love them. Thank you for participating. Before we go any further, though, we're going to ask Dorian to say a prayer for us over the rest of our night and kind of over our hearts. Let's do that now.
All right, let's pray. Lord, I want to thank you for everything you've given us. Thank you for your son. Thank you for the blessings. Thank you for the forgiveness that you give us for our sins, Lord. I want to ask you that you be with us tonight, that you be with everybody in their hearts, in their minds, and in their souls as we go through these times of being stuck in the house, being quarantined. I pray that you be with them in your presence, Lord, that you stick by their side, that they go to you, Lord, when they feel alone. To know that they're not alone, actually, that you're with them, that you're at their side, and that you always have their back. Please keep reminding them of that. Please keep showing them your love, your glory, and your grace. In Lord Jesus' name I say, amen.
Amen, amen. Hey, thank you, Dorian. So last week we talked about this dude named Jacob from the Bible. Do you remember him?
Yeah. He was the twin, right?
Yes.
The trickster.
Right.
The guy that took advantage of his starving brother,
yep.
Right? Lied to his dying father to steal a blessing from him.
Yeah, he lied to his dying father.
That's tragic.
To get ahead. Yeah, that's rotten. That's to the core. That's rotten, man. That's messed up. He's not somebody I think I want to be friends with.
Nah.
Quick test for you guys to see if you know or you remember the story. Maybe you heard it before, or maybe you were here with us last week and you know it. The first three people to respond, okay, wins a prize. Right?
Yeah.
There are three correct answers. Okay, the first people to respond with the correct answers wins. Now, you can only answer one time, and you can only write one answer, unless somebody else steals your answer. Like, you hit enter, and then somebody else, like, a fraction of a second before hit enter, right, and they took it. You can answer again if they stole
Ooh.
Your answer, right? Okay, so here it is. Are you ready?
Yeah.
So it's name being the operative word, right?
Give the names.
Okay. Name either Jacob's mother, father, or brother in the chat section. Go.
Go, go, go.
Yeah, so give the actual name. You got this.
Yes.
You got to look it up with Siri, do that. Okay, but hopefully some of you guys already know it, right?
So because Jacob acted the way that he did, he became homeless, lost his family,
yep.
Was afraid for his life because his brother was trying to kill him, and had to travel through the desert and sleep with rocks as a pillow.
Yeah, that's rough.
That's hard.
Yeah, it's hard like a pillow made of rock. So when I was thinking about the story, I was actually reading the story earlier this week, or last week. It doesn't matter. I was reading at some point, I had this thought in my head, because that's where I have thoughts instead of my elbow. And I was reading about Jacob, I was like, all the troubles that he was having, I was thinking, his life reminds me of an old school country song.
Huh.
You know the ones I'm talking about, right, Jessica?
Don't tell my brother, my big dumb older brother, I took his birthright, stole his blessing, yeah. 'Cause if you tell my brother, my big dumb older brother, he might blow up and kill me, yeah.
Ooh. Yeah, I can see that. I love a good song, and that's why we thought tonight's top five should be about popular songs.
Yeah. What we want to do is we want to start on a much more positive note, you know, especially since our Bible story tonight, it starts with a very deep and passionate love story.
Top five cringeworthy love songs.
Cringeworthy love songs. And to help us feel the full emotion of these songs, we actually invited a couple of serious performance poets named Rigel and Bob.
Bob.
To give their poetic interpretation of these songs.
Yeah, and coming in at number five is Every Breath You Take by The Police. Every breath you take, and every move you make, every bond you break, every step you take, I'll be watching you.
Yeah, that's not a love song. That's a stalker song.
Just a little bit.
Hey, number four. All right, Marry Me by Bruno Mars.
Ooh.
It's a beautiful, night. And we're looking for something dumb to do. Hey, baby. I think I want to marry you.
I'm not a master of romance, obviously, but that's not romantic.
No, it's not romantic.
Anyway, number three. Love Guppy by Sam Jones.
What?
I don't know. Let's find out. You shine like the rainbow bridge, or like the light inside my fridge. You're my love, Guppy. No time's too long for me to wait. For you, I'd fight against fate. Though maybe you could lose some weight. You are my love, Guppy.
You could lose some weight? Really?
You shine like the light in my fridge.
In my fridge. Because that's the brightest light. Right. The brightest light is the light that lights up my food, you know?
Ooh, yeah, I know, right?
Wow. Okay, sorry. That was wow. All right, number two. Baby, Justin Bieber.
Baby, oh, like.
And I was like, baby. Baby. Baby, oh. I was like, baby. Baby. Baby, no. I was like, baby. 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 Oh.
Anyways, number one. It's a classic Roses Are Red poem.
Roses are red, violets are blue. We have nothing in common. So baby, we're through.
Harsh, but honest. I mean, it's better than lying or ghosting them, I suppose, right?
True. Anyways, there you have it, folks. That's our top five cringeworthy love songs.
Wow, that is one sappy top five list.
Yeah, but tonight's story kind of starts out sappy too, doesn't it?
True. So if you guys would, go ahead and take, if you want to, if you have one, which I think you should either on your phone or, a hard copy, take out your Bible and turn to Genesis chapter 29, okay? So we're back to Jacob, and he's all alone searching for some relatives to take him in so he can figure out his life, right? To kind of rethink things,
right,
you know?
Right.
And he's trying to figure things out, right? And so one day as he's traveling, gets into the region where he thinks he has an uncle,
yeah.
Okay, Uncle Laban. He comes across a well, and there's some shepherds there with their sheep, okay? And he asks these guys, hey, I think I have a relative here. His name's Laban. I call him Uncle Laban, Unky Laban. Okay, and I'm wondering, have you guys heard of him? He's like, oh yeah, we know, we know. It's like, is he well? Oh yeah, he's real well. He goes, in fact, hey, look over there. See that girl? That's his daughter Rachel, and she's a shepherd. She's bringing sheep. And Jacob turns around, and I'm telling you, that's when he sees Rachel.
Rachel.
And she is gorgeous. I mean, it doesn't even matter that they're cousins. It's in the Bible. This girl, Rachel, is drop dead. Stop in traffic. Slap your mama gorgeous.
Slap your mama.
No, don't slap your mama. It was just an expression, all right? Don't actually do it ever.
You get yourself hurt.
That's right. But this girl is amazing. She is so pretty. He actually starts weeping. Look at it, Genesis 29. When he sees her, he starts weeping.
Imagine you just seen the most attractive person in the world. Mm. She is just straight took your breath away.
Yeah, her name is Janet.
How would you react? Would your jaw drop? Would you faint? Malachi, hey, Malachi, would you start giggling? would you drool a little?
Yeah, seriously. Send me a selfie of how you think you might respond if you saw that most attractive, amazingly incredibly hot person, hey, send it to me, text it to me, and then we'll try and share it next week. Jacob is so completely stunned that he decides, well, that he has to talk to her. I wonder if he tried to think, how can I impress her?
Hey, the well is that way.
What can I say? What can I do? Maybe start thinking of some impressive pickup lines. Oh. You know, maybe like some of these.
Hey girl, you like dogs by any chance? Cause I got this really cute one, and she's really nice. And if you want to, you can pet her. Say hi.
Oh, are you an old car? Cause you sure are a hot rod.
Hey, I know malls and movie theaters, sports venues may be closed, but my DMs are always open.
If I could rearrange the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
Did this song come out, or did you just smile at me?
Hey, you come within 6 feet of her often? Because if you need somebody to self-isolate with, I make a mean quarantino.
Hey, do you ever met, cause I see you get lost in your eyes.
Oh, what's up, girl? If I had a penny for every time I thought about you, I'd have exactly 1 cent, cause you never leave my mind, boo.
Hey, you know, I wonder if any of those lines would actually work, ever.
You never know till you try.
Yeah, true, but hey, write in the chat section your favorite pickup line that you just heard. You know, not some random one elsewhere, but the one that you just heard, all right? Anyway, look, we don't know what Jacob was thinking when he saw Rachel, okay? But what we do know is what the Bible tells us, and the Bible tells us this. Yeah. He immediately went, and he kissed her.
Oh, he went straight to it.
He kissed her, and then he started crying. I mean, dude started crying. So far in love, so fast. I mean, he was done for. He was overcome by emotion.
Hey,
he was just...
Hey. Why don't we let Uncle JoJo tell the rest of the story?
You know, I think that's a good idea.
Yeah. So, it's time again for story time with Uncle JoJo.
Uncle JoJo.
Bum, bum, ba, bum. Bum, bum. Oh, hey, everybody. Welcome to story time with Uncle JoJo. All right, now. I'm here in his wedding chapel because we're having a love story today, right? We're talking about Jacob, and we're talking about his love, Rachel, and we're talking about his other love, Leah, and we're talking about their daddy, Laban, right? So Jacob falls in love. He sees this girl, Rachel, right? And he falls in love, head over heels in love with Rachel. He's like, she's so pretty, right? I mean, she's prettier than a black and white glossy blue ribbon milk cow at the state fair, man. He was head over heels. And so he was like, I gotta marry this girl. Anyway, he and Uncle Laban, who soon to be father-in-law, strike up a deal. And what they say is this. 7 years Jacob's gonna work for Uncle Laban. 7 years! And after 7 years, for free, by the way, he can marry Rachel, right? And Jacob's like, 7 years? Whew! My love goes much farther than 7 years. I got this, right? So Jacob's like, I'm in, right? So he married, he doesn't marry, he works for 7 years for free, right? But it doesn't seem like 7 years because he's so in love, right? It only seems like 7 minutes or something, man. It was 7 days or something, man. He was in love. Anyway, the time came, 7 years was up. Right? And it was time to get married. And so, big celebration. Everybody comes to the party, and there's food, and there's feasting, right? And there's Uncle Laban brings out some wine, right? You know, brings out some moonshine, you know what I'm saying? Some alcohol, right? And he gives it to Jacob. Jacob's like, hey, why not? You know, I'm getting married. It's a happy day. So he has some alcohol, right? He gets some of the alcohol in his system, and then Uncle Laban gives him a little bit more alcohol, you know what I'm saying? And then a little bit more, right? And then some more, you know, and then it's like, okay, it's time to go get married, right? So he goes, he gets married, takes his wife home, and then the next morning he wakes up and he looks at his beautiful new wife and he realizes, wait, that ain't Rachel. What, that ain't Rachel. So he runs out of his house going, Uncle Laban, what have you done? Where's Rachel? And he's like, what have you done to me? I was supposed to marry Rachel. And Uncle Laban's like, hey, you know, man, it ain't our custom to marry off the younger daughter before marrying off the older daughter. So here's the deal. Well, I'll make a deal with you. If you promise to work for me for 7 more years for free, okay, I'll let you marry Rachel this week. And that's you go from 0 wives to 2 wives in 1 week, right? Pretty good, right? You know? And Jacob's like, well, I still love Rachel. I mean, that ain't gonna change, even though I'm married to Leah, right? I mean, because it's all kind of messed up. And he's like, okay, I'll do it, right? And so he goes from 0 to 2, and he's like, hey, you know, maybe if 1 wife is gonna be good, 2 wives are gonna be better. And I can tell you what, shoo, doggy, was he wrong?
Bruh, that was like a bad soap opera.
It really is. And the truth is, it only gets worse as it continues. But let's not forget, okay? Last week we talked about how God can use anyone mm-hmm. to accomplish his purposes, right? Even those of us that are most broken mm-hmm. and come from the most broken homes or broken families, God's not done with Jacob yet.
Good, because after last week, dude is a punk.
Yeah, he is.
It's interesting that Jacob, the trickster, got tricked by his uncle Laban. Mm. Almost like poetic justice.
Yeah, it's like working for 7 years for free so you can marry the woman of your dreams. Only to get tricked into working another 7 years after secretly being tricked into marrying someone else entirely. It's just crazy.
Why do people in Jacob's family keep being so selfish?
Right? I mean, it was going to be this epic love story, right? And then it was turned into this epic soap opera of family problems. I mean, Jacob's cousin sister wives immediately
start... Cousin sister's wife?
Yeah, yeah. So Jacob is their cousin. Uh-huh. They're his cousins. Yeah. And then they're sisters. And then he marries them both. So they're cousin sister wives. It's in the Bible. Check it out. Genesis 29. Seriously. So Jacob's... Okay. Cousin sister wives immediately start fighting with each other over their new husband. And then later, even their children start fighting. I mean, it's ridiculous.
It's crazy.
We start to see the consequences that come with this selfishness. Consequences that affect more than just Jacob and Laban.
Yeah. When Jacob took advantage of his brother and lied to his father, his family was literally broken apart with murder on Esau's mind.
Yeah, and when Laban decided to get both of his daughters married off, plus 14 years of free labor, right? It was a great deal for him, but it was terrible for his daughters.
Yeah.
And it was terrible for his nephew / son-in-law. And it was terrible for his grandchildren. I mean, you guys have heard of Joseph in the coat of many colors, right? Okay. His brothers hate him. He has the dreams, right? And he's all like, hey, y'all gonna bow down to me, right? And his brothers hate him. And they attack him. And then they sell him into slavery. Guess whose sons those guys were?
Who?
It was Jacob's.
Oh.
Jacob's family is just messed up. You might be asking yourself this. What good can we learn from these events in Jacob's life?
That's exactly what I was thinking. I'm still waiting to see why Jacob's story is in the Bible at all.
Well, here's the thing. There's actually quite a bit that we can learn from the story, but we're only gonna grab onto one tonight that applies to our lives specifically.
Yeah.
And that is this. There's a difference between what you can do
right.
and what is right to do.
Okay.
Okay. Or said maybe another way, there's a difference between what you can you get away with and what you should do.
Okay. Think about it this way. You want to go see a movie with your friends, right? And you know your parents won't let you go see it. You think you should be allowed to see it? I mean, why not? If you ask your parents, they say no. But you realize that all you really got to go do is tell your mom, hey, mama, I'm going over a friend's house. I'll see you later. And then... what you really do is you sneak off and go see the movie you were told not to see. You can work it out so you can go see the movie, but you know, you shouldn't.
Yeah. See, Laban was in that same situation, right? He knew he could trick Jacob, his nephew, into marrying both of his daughters.
Mm-hmm.
He could get 14 years of free labor. He could keep his family close. He could get lots of grandchildren. He could have his little kingdom of his family.
Right.
He could do that, but he shouldn't have done that. He should have been honest.
Right.
See, some people call that distinction what you can and what you should.
Right.
Okay. They call that ethics or morality. Doing the right thing when you can get away with doing the you know, something that's not right.
Mm-hmm. Like when your teacher leaves the classroom, and then you could decide to have integrity and be good, or to not have integrity and do what's wrong.
Great. Okay, good. Now, God calls that
righteous
living, or just living right. In the Bible, in Proverbs chapter 21, verse 3, it says this: to do what is right and just is more acceptable to God, to the Lord, than sacrifice.
Right. And Titus chapter 2, verses 11 to 12 says, for the grace of God has appeared that offers salvation to all people. It teaches us to say no to ungodliness and worldly passions and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in this present age.
Yeah. This message is really important for us. It really does hit us today, maybe more than we want it to.
Yeah.
There are so many things that we can do, that we have access to do, that maybe we shouldn't.
You can yell at your parents.
But you should respect them.
You can illegally download movies and music.
Yeah, but you should pay for those things, or just don't watch them or listen to them.
You can sneak off with your girlfriend or boyfriend and sleep with them.
Okay, but you should treat each other, especially those closest to you, with purity and respect until marriage.
You can bully someone, laugh at them, treat them badly.
But what you should do is you should protect them. You know, there are things that you can do that you shouldn't do. And there are a ton of things in this world and in us that try to convince us that sinful living, that doing things that aren't right, that aren't moral, that aren't righteous, as God would put it, are okay. But God is calling us to something higher than that. Do you remember this? You have called me higher, you have called me deeper, and I'll go where you would send me, Lord. Yeah? You have called me higher, you have called me deeper, and I'll go where you would send me, Lord. You send me, Lord. See, God is telling us to live righteously, to live right. He's calling us to something greater.
Mm-hmm. So, this is our challenge for you this week. Let's all take a few moments this week and think about the things we are doing on a daily. Things we say, shows we watch, music we listen to, and ask yourself this: is this something I should do? Or is this just something I can get away with? Then pray for God's guidance to help you stop.
From Numbers chapter 6, verse 24 to 25. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and give you peace. All right, hey, everybody, thank you so much for being with us and participating, right? It's awesome. We love you guys, and we appreciate you. And so I don't know if you guys remember hearing this last week, but Dorian announced it in the announcement time, that if anybody that goes to the video that we did on our YouTube channel,
right,
called I'm Going Crazy Here, and then they go into the comment section and write a, you know, some sort of critical review that we would give a prize. Malachi was the only one to do that. And so Malachi is getting a $20 e-gift card to Papa John's. I'm going to give you guys another chance. If you guys want to go do that to that video, the I'm Going Crazy Here video, write a kind of a critique, a 2 to 5 sentence long critique, and maybe how it relates to our sometimes to our relationship with God. Hey, we love you guys, and we miss you. You got anything?
I'm good, but hey, Jesus loves you. Absolutely. Remember that.
This I know. This you know. All right, hey, we'll see you guys next time. Peace!
I'm hearing a DJ rocking the beat, he was blaring that old school hip-hop, I was so unaware of it. I never heard a beat bang more harder before that. I wanted that record, but I couldn't afford that. So Mr. DJ, would you play my beat one more time and hit the rhyme before I lose my mind? Yeah, bring the beat back.